Problem 7 from exercise 14B. So first part of the problem, you need to find the values of x and y. So I'll just read the question. He says this, the question says ABCD is a parallelogram and find the value of x and y. ABCD is a parallelogram and find the values of x and y. So because this is a parallelogram, immediately I have this, this side and this side are parallel to each other and they are equal to each other. Similarly, this side and this side, AD and then BC are parallel and equal to each other. So how will I solve this? How will I find the value of x and y? So AD is equal to BC. Therefore, 4y is equal to 3x minus 3. Okay. 4y minus 3x is equal to 3. Can you simplify this equation further? I mean, any common factor? No common factor. So I'll call this equation 1. Similarly, DC is equal to AB. DC is equal to AB. What is DC? 6y plus 2 equals 4x. So take this 4x on the other side. 6y minus 4x is equal to minus 2. I am taking this, bringing this 2 on the other side. That's all I am doing. Therefore, it becomes minus 2. Now, any common factor here? Yes, the entire expression can be divided by 2. So 6 divided by 2 gives me 3y. 4 divided by 4x by 2 is 2x, minus 2 by 2 is minus 1. So I'll call this equation 2. Okay. Now compare equation 1 and equation 2. I have 4y and then 3y. So what I will do is I'll multiply this equation 1 into I'll multiply this with 3. Gives me 3 fours are 12y minus 9x is equal to 9, and I'll multiply equation 2 with 4 and I'll get 12y minus 8x is equal to minus 4. Now I will subtract these two equations. I will subtract these two equations. 12y minus 12y gives me 0. I'll not write it. 9x minus minus 8x. So it is minus 9x plus 8x. Minus x is equal to 9 minus minus 4, which is 9 plus 4, 13. Or x is equal to minus 13. Damn it, man. All right, we'll solve problem 7. It has two sub problems, sub problem 1 and sub problem 2. Before we proceed with those, before we proceed with the solution, let us try to understand the question clearly. Pretty simple question. He says that ABCD is a parallelogram and we need to find the value of y and x from the given data. Now, because this is a parallelogram, AB will be equal to CD. AB is equal to CD and they are parallel to each other. Therefore, I have indicated that with this arrow marks. And similarly, AD is parallel to CB. And therefore, these two are indicated with this double arrow marks. So now, solution. First, I'll write AD is equal to BC and AD is equal to 4y and BC is equal to 3x minus 3. I'll send this 3x on the other side. It becomes 4y minus 3x is equal to minus 3. Minus 3 remains here as it is on the right hand side. 4y minus 3x is equal to minus 3. I'm calling this equation 1. And next, similarly, we have DC is equal to AB. DC is equal to AB. What is DC? 6y plus 2 is equal to AB is 4x. I'll take this 4x on the other side and I'll bring this 2 here. 6y minus 4x equals minus 2. And can I simplify this further? Yes, I can simplify. There is 2 common factor. So this becomes 3y minus 2x is equal to minus 1. And I'm going to call this equation 2. Now I'll write this equation 1 and equation 2 together. Consider equation 1 and equation 2. Write it here. Okay. Consider equation 1 and 2. Equation 1 is 4y minus 3x equals minus 3, and then equation 2 is 3y minus 2x is equal to minus 1. So now I just need to solve these two equations, simultaneous equations, to find the value of x and y. To solve this, what I will do is I'll multiply this with 3 and this I'll multiply with 4, and then I get 12y minus 9x is equal to minus 9, and here I will get 12y minus 8x is equal to minus 4. Now I will subtract these two equations. So 12y minus 12y gives me 0. Minus 9x minus minus 8x. Minus 9x plus 8x gives me minus x is equal to minus 9 minus of minus 4. So which is minus 9 plus 4. Gives me minus 5, or x is equal to 5. We found the value of x. X is equal to 5. Now substitute this value, x is equal to 5. Substitute this value in any one of the equations and find the value of y. Let me substitute this in which one? I'll substitute this in equation 1. Substitute value of x in equation 1. So then I get 4y minus 3 into 5 is equal to minus 3. 4y minus 15 equals minus 3. 4y is equal to 15 minus 3. So I don't have space, therefore I'll write like this. 4y, sorry. I don't have space, so I'll continue writing here. 4y is equal to 12 and y is equal to 3. That's it. We move to the second part of the question. This is the second part of the question. So he gives another diagram and these are the angles. So based on this information, we need to find the value of x and y. Now in this, because this is a rectangle, angle D is equal to angle B. Reason, opposite angles. Opposite angles are equal. So which means 6x plus 3y minus 8 is equal to 7y. D is this and B is this. 6x plus 3y minus 8 is equal to 7y. So quickly solve this. 6x plus 3y minus 7y is equal to, send this minus 8 on the other side, becomes positive 8. So 6x, 3 minus 7 gives you minus 4y is equal to 8. And then I see that 2 is common. I can divide the entire equation by 2. So that gives me 3x minus 2y is equal to 4. I call this equation 1. And then similarly, what I can do is, this angle, this D, this angle and this angle, if I add, I should get 180, because adjacent angles add to 180 degree in a parallelogram. You can say adjacent angles are conjoint angles. So angle A plus angle B is equal to 180 degree. Reason, adjacent angles or conjoint angles. So now angle A is 4x plus 20 and angle B is 7y is equal to 180 degree. 4x plus 7y equals, I'll send this 20 on the other side, it becomes 180 minus 20. So 4x plus 7y is equal to 160. This is equation 2. Okay. As usual, like how I considered in the previous problem, I'll write equation 1 and equation 2 together. Consider equation 1 and equation 2. Three x minus 2y equals 4, and then 4x plus 7y equals 160. I'll multiply this equation with 4, and then I'll multiply this equation with 3, and that gives me 12x minus 8y is equal to 16, and this gives me 12x plus 21y is equal to 160 into 3. 160 into 3 will be 480. Now I will subtract these two equations. I'll subtract these two equations. When I do that, 12x minus 12x is 0, minus 8 minus plus 21y. So minus 8 minus 21 gives me minus 29y equals 16 minus 480. 16 minus 480 gives me minus 464, or 29y is equal to 464. Y is equal to 464 divided by 29, and that is equal to 13. Sorry, this is equal to 16. 464 divided by 29 gives me 16. Now I found the value of y, and I need to substitute this value in any one of the equation. Substitute, so just make a note of this, put this in a box. Y is equal to 16, or wait, let me rewrite it again. So here we have y is equal to 16. Substitute this in. In equation 1, 3x minus 2 into y, instead of y I am writing 16 is equal to 4. 3x minus 32 equals 4. 3x is equal to 32 plus 4. 3x is equal to 36. X is equal to 36 by 3, which is 13.